The first stable settlements on the site date back to the 8th century BC when the Oscans, a people of central Italy, founded five villages in the area. In the early 6th century BC, the settlement merged into a single community centered on the important crossroad between Cumae, Nola, and Stabiae and was surrounded by a tufa city wall. The first wall unusually enclosed a much greater area than the early town together with much agricultural land. That such an impressive wall was built at this time indicates that the settlement was already important and wealthy. In 524 BC the Etruscans arrived and settled in the area, including Pompeii, finding in the River Sarno a communication route between the sea and the interior. Like the Greeks, the Etruscans did not conquer the city militarily, but simply controlled it and Pompeii enjoyed a sort of autonomy. Nevertheless, Pompeii became a member of the Etruscan League of Cities. The city wall was strengthened in the early 5th century BC with two facades of relatively thin, vertically set, slabs of Sarno limestone some 4 meters apart filled with earth. In 474 BC the Greek city of Cumae, allied with Syracuse, defeated the Etruscans at the Battle of Cumae and gained control of the area. The period between about 450 to 375 BC witnessed large areas of the city being abandoned while important sanctuaries such as the Temple of Apollo show a sudden lack of votive material remains. The Samnites, people from the areas of Abruzzo and Molise, and allies of the Romans, conquered Greek Cumae between 423 and 420 BC and it is likely that all the surrounding territory, including Pompeii, was already conquered around 424 BC. From 343 to 341 BC in the Samnite Wars, the first Roman army entered the Campanian plain bringing with it the customs and traditions of Rome, and in the Roman-Latin War from 340 BC the Samnites were faithful to Rome. Pompeii, although governed by the Samnites, entered the Roman orbit, to which it remained faithful even during the Third Samnite War and in the war against Pyrrhus. The city walls were reinforced in Sarno stone in the early 3rd century BC. It formed the basis for the currently visible walls with an outer wall of rectangular limestone blocks as a terrace wall supporting a large auger, or earth embankment, behind it. After the Samnite Wars from 290 BC, Pompeii was forced to accept the status of socii of Rome, maintaining, however, linguistic and administrative autonomy. From the outbreak of the Second Punic War in which Pompeii remained faithful to Rome, an additional internal wall was built of tufa and the internal auger and outer facade raised resulting in a double parapet with wider wall walk. Many nearby buildings inside the walls were also destroyed. Many of Sulla's veterans were given land and property in and around the city, while many of those who opposed Rome were dispossessed of their property. The main language in the city became Latin, and many of Pompeii's old aristocratic families Latinized their names as a sign of assimilation. The city became an important passage for goods that arrived by sea and had to be sent toward Rome or southern Italy along the nearby Appian Way. Many public buildings were built or refurbished and improved under the new order. New buildings included the amphitheater in 70 BC, the Forum Baths and the Teatrum Tectum while the Forum was embellished with the colonnade of Popidius before 80 BC. These buildings raised the status of Pompeii as a cultural center in the region as it outshone its neighbors in the number of places for entertainment which significantly enhanced the social and economic development of the city. Under Augustus from about 30 BC a major expansion in new public buildings, as in the rest of the empire, included the Eumachia building, the sanctuary of Augustus and the Macellum. The inhabitants of Pompeii had long been used to minor earthquakes, but on 5 February 62 a severe earthquake did considerable damage around the bay, and particularly to Pompeii. The nearby cities of Herculaneum and Nuceria were also affected. In the public sector the opportunity was taken to improve buildings and the city planned for example in the Forum. The public buildings on the east side of the Forum were largely restored and were even enhanced by beautiful marble veneers and other modifications to the architecture. This shows that the city was still flourishing rather than struggling to recover from the earthquake. The eruption lasted for 2 days. Pliny the Younger provided a first-hand account of the eruption of Mount Vesuvius from his position across the Bay of Naples at Misenum but written 25 years after the event. Volcanologists have recognized the importance of Pliny the Younger's account of the eruption by calling similar events Plinian. It had long been thought that the eruption was an August event based on one version of the letter but another version gives a date of the eruption as late as 23rd of November. Clear support for an October/November eruption is found in the fact that people buried in the ash appear to have been wearing heavier clothing than the light summer clothes typical of August. The fresh fruit and vegetables in the shops are typical of October, and conversely the summer fruit typical of August was already being sold in dried, or conserved form.